evening and a warm welcome to IC. Which IC? Come on.
14.
Yes, we were thinking. We should think now. Well, we all hear the saying that Big Brother is watching you. Haven't we heard it?
Yes.
But today we have our dear friend Rajesh, who's going to tell us who the Big Brother is. So let's look at the AV and see and find out.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. It's always a pleasure to meet and greet you for another interesting session of inspiring conversations. No one ever said it was easy being an entrepreneur. Whether you are in the early stages of your startup, just secured funding for your growth, or you are ready for a new product launch or business expansion, entrepreneurship always has its own challenges. A lot of people have ideas, but there are a few who decide to do something about them. Not today, tomorrow, or next week, but now. The true entrepreneur is a doer, not a dreamer. Friends, today's chief guest is Mr. Pramoud Rao. Mr. Pramoud Rao is the promoter, managing director of ZICOM Group. Pramoud Rao has been instrumental in bringing about a paradigm change in the Indian electronic security business with a vision that the future of safety and security lay in technology-driven security solutions. It's not about ideas, it's about making ideas happen. Since 1994, the year ZICOM Electronic Security Systems Limited was founded, Pramoud Rao has led the organized electronic security movement in India through a strategic and visionary approach in many ways, and in the process, he has also made sure that ZICOM becomes a synonymous name with the electronic security in the country. The price of success is hard work, dedication to the job at hand, and the determination that whether we win or lose, we have applied the best of ourselves to the task at hand. Always we need to risk more than others think it is safe. We should always dream more than others think what is practical. Mr. Rao has been a trendsetter, well exhibited with the launch of his innovative concept called ESAS, which means electronic security as a service, and distinguishing the company as a differentiator in the marketplace through this path-breaking concept. Be undeniably good. No marketing effort or social media buzzword can be a substitute for that. Despite all the odds, Mr. Pramoud Rao has made a success story for the group, ensuring that it attains a dominant status in the electronic security market. Timing, perseverance, and many years of trying will eventually make you look like an overnight success. Mr. Pramoud Rao's vision is to make technology-driven security solutions so affordable that every Indian home, every office, every store, every mall, every public transport point, every institution in India will feel safe. Mr. Pramoud Rao is the former National President of Fire and Security Association of India. He is also the former Security Ambassador for Schneider for the Asia Pacific region. Entrepreneurship is neither a science nor an art. It's a practice. No matter what people tell you, words and ideas can change this world. Ladies and gentlemen, let's put our hands together and welcome Mr. Pramoud Rao. Pramoud Rao definitely gives us a feeling of feel safe. And feel safe is the tagline of ZICOM. Thanks for being at Inspiring Conversations, Pramoud.
You know, Rajesh, one of the first things that I got to know is that if you want to be a great human being, you should know names of people. That's the first qualification. And you know, I have this disease and don't remember people's name. And I was absolutely amused the way you were going about each and every person's name you knew, except one. I was trying to count how many misses he's going to have. Amazing. I mean, that's a quality is incredible, man.
Thank you. Thank you, Pramoud. That doesn't make you escape from tough questions. So who is Pramoud Rao? The audience would like to know, who is Pramoud Rao, the entrepreneur?
Well, you know, there is no ego massaging today. I'm going to be very candid. So I started my career, in my school days. I was the last batch of that 11 plus 4, before 10 plus 2 plus 3 got introduced. So I remember when I was in the 9th standard, the government announced, aage se abhi 11 plus 4 band hoke, 10 plus 2 plus 3 hoga. And I was never good in studies. So 9th, I failed in 3 subjects. So, but they had no choice because aise band hone wala tha. So they said, condoned and promoted. So I went to 10th. 10th, I did a little better, I failed only in 2. 9th, so record improve ho gaya. So, wahan pe, again condoned and promoted. Fir pata nahi kya ho gaya, SSC mein ekdam pass. But very poor marks. So once I passed SSC, you know, with that 40 or 41% marks, there's only one college I thought I'll get admission, but that was called Junjunwala in Ghatkopar. So wahan jaake, I started my studies, but fortunately never failed any year, I don't know how. But I passed my graduation. And once I passed my graduation, I started going for jobs, interviews. And after many interviews, I didn't get a job anywhere. So I turned to my father, I said, Dad, I think I can speak quite well. I speak okay. Thoda style belt mein maar bhi leta hu main kabhi. Aur my English also is fine. Dekhne mein bhi, at that time I had little hair on my head. So matlab dekhne mein bhi theek thaak lag raha hu. Lekin why don't I get a job? So he told me, son, it's all style and no substance in it. So when you go for interview, they can easily make that out. So I said, haan, barabar hai. Maybe jyada style maarta hu, kuch andar kuch hai nahi. Padhai kuch kiya nahi hum log ne. So then I said, Dad, now, what do? I mean, he said, now I can't put you back to school. Wo sab khatam hoga time. So I said, fir kya karne ga? So he said, use common sense. So when he said, use common sense, I was like, Dad, give me something better na. Kya, what is common sense now? I was too young to understand the meaning of common sense. So to answer your question, today I use my common sense because I didn't go to any school and management colleges, and that's what helped me in my life. So that's what Pramoud Rao is all about. I use my common sense and whatever little things I do.
Why the security industry? Because electronic security, when you started it in 1995, it was not the trend to be believing in electronic security. We still had the Gurkhas and the guards outside our buildings and houses. So what gave you the thought of initiating into the electronic security business? What inspired you?
Well, it so happened that fortunately got a job finally in a pharma company. I became a medical rep. I used to sell medicine to doctors. Boring job, you know, when you go to a doctor's place, wo tereko 2-2 ghanta bahar bitata hai. And when you go inside, he doesn't look at your face also. Kya job hai, bekar. So after 1 year, I quit. I worked in some companies. In 1988, my mother used to work for BRC. So we were staying in the quarters, and one evening after playing cricket, two of us got together, me and my friend, and we started discussing our business life. We said, let's start a business. I said, okay. So how much money? I said, 5,000 rupees. I said, okay, I'll bring 5, you bring 5. Aisa karke, we started a company, and I remember Ravi, I used to meet you in those days. Yeah, and Silver. So we started the business together, and we got into fax machines. And in those days, fax machines like washing machines.
Jayanti business machines.
Jayanti business machines, yeah. So fax machines like washing machines, huge. Like, we can't take it out. So wo chalu kiya, and with 10,000 rupees in our pocket, and by 1994, we crossed about 50-odd crore revenue in that office automation business. And then, hamara public issue aaya. Aur us zamane mein, between public issue and allotment, there is 90 days. Abhi to fat-fat karke ho jata hai. Us zamane mein, they used to give 90 days. So me and my partner were sitting in baju mein, apna isme orchid ke andar. So in that 90 days, so there was one topic on which we had a small fight. And main to jara impulsive hoon. So maine isko bola, main company chhod ke ja raha hoon. To bola, kya? Bola, main company chhod ke ja raha hoon. To bola, mad or what? Main ja raha hoon. Bola, ja. But I'll not give you anything. Bola, leke kya aaya tha jaane. It's okay, I didn't come with anything, I'll go with anything. So what? So that's how I left. And when I left, I started ZICOM, and that's how the security industry I got into.
So you, did you get the IPO money to activate the ZICOM, or again you started from the scratch?
So when I left Jayanti, and then the stock got listed on the stock exchange, and it got listed at 9 rupees, and had a dream run till 220 rupees. So my friend told me, idiot, I told you not to leave. Ego bigo leke gaya, mala theek hai yaar, sabke naseeb mein jo jo likha hai wo hota hai. So I had some 16, 17 rupees in my bank, and with that I started ZICOM. Ye apna MIG cricket club hai na, Bandra East mein. Uske samne jo, there were small, that buildings are there. In that one I took a small office, wahan se chalu kiya. And the name actually, that com stood for communication. So in 1994, you know, pages came. So I started with pages, and then in about less than 1 year, mobiles came. And there was something called as modem, which everybody has forgotten now. We used to sell modems at 2 lakh rupees in those days. So that was, we used to call it ZCOM, not ZICOM. Z television, not Z television, that was the first private channel. So everybody knew Z.
Around
94. Doordarshan ke baad Z aaya. So humne bola isko Z ko pakdo aur com dal do, ZCOM.
So that's a typical entrepreneur who took leverage of existing infrastructure of somebody else.
It was very easy. उसके बाद मैं गलती से मैं बोला यार ये तो क्या ट्रेडिंग का बिजनेस है हचिसन मैक्स से लो मैक्स टच था उस जमाने में एंड मोटरोला से ये लो पेजर लो मतलब इसमें यू कैन नॉट बिल्ड एन ऑर्गेनाइजेशन विद ट्रेडिंग इन दिस काइंड ऑफ बिजनेसेस सो आई सेड लेट मी गो टू स्टार्ट समथिंग न्यू तो अराउंड दैट टाइम देयर वाज अ न्यू बजवर्ड कॉल्ड Y2K मैं बोला Y2K होता क्या है Then they said, oh, kuch, you know, virus, virus and all that stuff. I didn't understand what it is. Anyway, so I said, security mein jaate hain hum log. 1993, remember the bomb blast took place?
Yes, bomb the scenario changed after that.
Scenario changed. I'm like, chalo, ye business karte hain hum log. So I went to US and when I gave my ZCOM card, they said, ZICOM. I'm like, ye to achha lag raha, yaar. This is much more firangi. So I said, operator ko bola, madam, it is not ZCOM, it's ZICOM. So that's how the pronunciation changed. And we got into that business. But you know, like all entrepreneurs, hunch is too strong. But the markets were not there. And we struggled for many years. So that's how we started the security business in the country.
My question to you, Pramod, is you saw two stock markets at a very young time, at a very young age. Because that is the age where most of the entrepreneurs struggle and suffer for funds, for capital. And you had the guts to get into the stock market quickly. In fact, in the first year of your ZICOM times for the security business, you became a listed company.
Yeah.
So was the experience of the first IPO beneficial for you for the second one?
Of course. And also, I don't think it was guts. I think it was more out of need. Paisa nahi tha to somebody had to pay for the...
Who guided you to doing all this? Because we are all entrepreneurs, but we don't get people who induce us to getting into the stock market.
So when I was going for IPO in Jayanti, I met a friend of mine called Manohar Bhide, who is my partner today for the last 20 years. And he was a company secretary, legal expert and all. So, usne mereko bola aisa issue nikalne ka and all that. So, we joined hands together and we started ZICOM. So, that's how, so he takes care of all the market and stock market, listing, legal and all. I'm not good at it. Or not.
So, with no money, suddenly when you got a lot of money because of the stock market, how did you deploy it for your establishing your business? What were your plans then?
You know, any new business, one of the mistakes that most entrepreneurs make, and I also make even after giving all this gyan, is that when you start a new concept, you should never invest your own money. Because what happens is, like today look, all these Flipkarts and all what they're doing, they're taking somebody else's money. Because new concepts, you're not very sure whether it'll do well or not do well. But in those days, there was nothing like private equity and all. You know, those days, there was no concepts of private equity. Today is there. So we took the risk. And in the year 2001, we went bankrupt. And then we were almost trying to save ourselves. And something good happened, and then we survived. And so we have seen enough ups and downs in our life. But I think most of the time, finance has been a challenge, primarily because businesses go through a lot of transitions, sometimes good, sometimes bad. So I think that's any part and parcel of any business.
What is your compliances management strategy? Because whether you do good or you do bad, the compliances are in place. The government authorities are definitely keeping a watch on every entrepreneur. Yeah. So what was your compliance management strategy? When it was good times, it's easy to manage. But when it is tough times, the compliances don't change. So how did you handle that?
You know, one of the things about listed companies is corporate governance. So we get also rated on corporate governance a lot of times. And so far, we have been quite okay. I'm not saying we are one of the best corporate governed companies, because when I go for shareholders meetings, our shareholders are very demanding. So we are doing our best. So compliance has been something which every listed company, like it or don't like it, needs to follow. And we are following it very strictly in our company also. And right now, there are so many disclosures. If you open any company's annual report, everything has to be disclosed. So I think things have changed, and it's for the good for investors also.
So is it good to be answerable to the shareholders so that they propel you to go for further growth? If you're a sincere company, definitely the shareholders becomes your backbone.
It is not about sincerity or nonsense. I think it is the mindset of an entrepreneur. If you want to grow and you don't have the money, today you have alternatives like private equity. In those days, it was not there. So we went public. But again, Ravi will also agree with me. You know, he also was running a listed company. It has its own problems. Even a person who buys 1,000 shares can question you, can write to you, can tell you a lot of things about you. But if you're okay with all that stuff, you can go listed. Otherwise, it's better to remain private. Today, when I look back, I find, did I do the right thing or the wrong thing? I get both the answers. I'm not very sure. Sometimes I felt it was better if we didn't go listed. Sometimes we felt if we had not gone listed, we would not have grown so big. So there's always an internal debate about that.
When you got into e-security, the market locally was strong, but you also ventured into the other countries. And you also ventured into the Middle East, Hong Kong, and including China. The company which would be definitely manufacturing a lot of security stuff. You also have them as clients. So what was your strategy jumping out of the country?
Well, you know, aspirations never end. And we are WIP, work in progress all the time. So one of the things, one day I went to Dubai for a holiday, and I said we should be in Dubai. So we did an acquisition in 2007, followed up by another acquisition in 2011. But the interesting part is in Dubai, we don't do any security. We only do fire. We don't touch security in Dubai. In India, we do only security. And very lately, last week, we got the contract for the Burj Khalifa. So that world's tallest building is managed by us now. And we also did the Dubai Terminal 4, Terminal 5, Terminal 6. So we are A-grade contractors in that part of the world. And we do large projects out there and very, very high-quality projects also. So we do fire in Dubai, and in India, we only do security. That's the distinction.
Amongst the people who benefited in the country because of IT, the Narayan Murthys and the Infosys and the Wipros, I think one more gentleman who benefited a lot with the IT boom in India is ZICOM.
Yeah.
Because convergence happened, and with the help of technology, security really changed the face of the industry in this country. How did you use IT to your advantage?
Well, in 2010, you know, we looked at the whole business and we found that there were lots of projects coming, especially on the city surveillance. We did Bombay City, we did Bangalore City, we did Jaipur City, Bharuch, Chandigarh.
More than 70 cities in India, if I'm not wrong?
No, we did about 12 cities, that's all we did. And then this business, we also got the Commonwealth Games, luckily not through Suresh Kalmadi. We got it from... from ECIL. But anyway, that business we sold to Schneider Electric in the year 2010.
Now, well, I've got a separate question for that activity.
Sure.
What you did with Schneider.
Okay, so then what happened was, you know, these multinational companies, when you sell yourself, they tie your hands, they tie your legs, they tied everything of us. So we had the brand, but we didn't have the business. So, and they gave me a nice fancy title, security ambassador in Asia Pacific, say Schneider and all. I felt very nice, but kuch kaam to tha nahi mere ko uske andar. So, main bola abhi karun kya, brand is there. Our stock was around 270, it came to $25. 90% erosion on value.
What was the reason for that?
Investor said, yaar, we declared 50% dividend. Investor said, bahut acha kiya, but abhi kya karoge? So, we didn't know what to do because security is the only thing we have learned in our life.
What did you do with the 225 crores that Schneider gave you?
There was some debts to be honored, and we had kept some capital for new businesses. So what that business was, we were not very sure. And around that time, we ideated on a concept. That concept, in my opinion, will revolutionize the way security is done in the country. We have already started it. And we're doing quite well on that business. And I'm very confident that in the next 2 to 3 years, the whole industry of security will transform or I will take that path that we have started. We are pioneering this concept again, and we're seeing great success out there right now.
You are not from an IT background, but still you are doing a business which is 99% dependent on IT. How did you manage the transition?
Common sense. So, I'm right now in a business called IoT. It's called Internet of Things. So we looked at the internet market. 350 million Indians are today using internet. So we said, if we can build a business model around the internet, that's going to be great business for us. But how to plug in security with internet was the question. Second, we said, if it is internet, the second sexy thing in the market today is something called as M2M, machine to machine. Yeah, people who are IT, who are familiar with IT, will understand what I'm trying to say. And then there were a lot of those jargons, BYOD, bring your own devices, RMR, recurring monthly revenue. So all that things were happening. So we said, ye pure ko hum log ek business model mein convert karna hai. And that's what our business model is. So how it essentially works, Rajesh, just to tell you, is that, I'll give you an example so that you can understand it better. When you look at any ATM today, which we go to withdraw cash, you see a watchman standing outside. If you look at the banks, ATM is a cost center for them because they have to pay 30,000-40,000 rupees to the security guard. So we went and told the banks, why do you need a guard? Make us the electronic security guard. And if you are paying 40,000, you just pay us 4,000. And we will do almost the same job, except cleaning hum nahi karenge, but manage karne ka kaam hum karenge. So Punjab National Bank was the first bank that took the bold step of removing the guards and putting electronic security. So let me tell you what happens. And this happened just 3 days back in Jaipur. So 4 o'clock in the morning, one guy walks in into an ATM. He's carrying with him a Chinese cutting machine, so laser cutter. He comes and he starts cutting it. The minute he starts cutting it, we have sensors all over. There's a heat sensor, so the heat sensor catches the sensor. And using the internet, it tells our command center that ye Jaipur ka ATM mein, somebody is doing a mischief. So my guy sitting in the command center, 4 o'clock in the morning, switches on the video and sees a guy who's cutting it. So then he does a two-way audio. He says, bhai sahab, main aapko dekh raha hoon, aap ATM ko chori karne ko try kar rahe ho, aap abhi gas cutting kar rahe ho, abhi aap ja rahe ho ki nahi ja rahe ho, ki main police ko bulaun. So that guy looks here and there, he doesn't know from where the sound is coming, okay? So then he still wants to continue. So because he was continuing, my guy switches on the alarm from Bombay. It's happening in Jaipur. So the alarm starts there, and this guy gets scared. He takes his machine and runs away. We call the police. The police comes in 10 minutes, and this whole incident is captured at the local site, captured at our end, and we hand it over to the police and the bank. Now what has happened is, here we prevented an ATM robbery. Also the bank that spends 40,000 rupees now has to only spend 4,000 rupees, and they save so much of money. So that's the kind of technology that we are promoting.
And this concept that you started was something innovation in this country. It is known as eSaaS.
eSaaS, yes.
Security SaaS. As a...
Yeah, wo SaaS jo tha na, wo SaaS bhi kabhi bahut hi na. Usse inspire ho gaye hum log.
Security as a service.
Usko humne security as a service kar dala.
But the flip side of that model, which I studied because I was doing a research on you, is that when you give security as a service, your investment multiplies because you are going to take it in installments from the client. Mm. But to deploy it at the client's side on day one, you need to have that kind of money in place. So how did you manage that situation?
Well, we managed it. That's why I'm sitting in front of you today. But our investors are not very happy. So they are saying, kya itna paisa lete rehte ho? Ek site aata na Rajesh, hum log, like for example, one residential building in Bombay. Today we have 4,000 residential buildings in Bombay where we have got installed our system. Each building costs us 50 to 60,000 rupees. So every building, every day we get itna paisa dalna padta hai. And we have to borrow. Because apne paas itna, this is a growth business.
It's more of financial management then.
Yeah, so then the investors don't like it. So we've now converted that whole model into a leasing model. So we have leasing companies finally supporting us on that model.
Okay, so that is how you do the money management. The leasing company will buy the product from you, lease it to the client, and the installment pays you as well as to the leasing company.
Yeah, so we collect the money and the lease servicing is done by us.
Many a times, Pramod, an entrepreneur in the zeal of expansion and fast growth, forgets the proportion of debt he creates on his company and himself. How does one balance it? You have been experiencing it right from the time you started business. So what is the right proportion? Where will I understand what is the right proportion to manage the debt?
You know, I am actually on the other side of the coin. Today, on my balance sheet, there's huge debt. So that's one of the concerns the investors are telling. But if one goes to analyze the debt, it has gone in acquisition and all these investments. So I find it very funny, personally, I'm talking from a personal perspective, that growth businesses need cash. So if the markets are not doing well, the only way to do is to either raise equity or go to banks. So we went to the banks, we didn't raise equity. So right now, to tell you very honestly, the leasing has been a great silver lining for us, a saving for us. So we are now stopped our debt taking. So we are now funding it to lease. This business is a great business because it gives you more than 60% EBITDA margins. I don't think in today's time it's easy to get 60% plus EBITDA margins. Having said that, the challenge still remains that it constantly swallows cash because of this model. So we started a new model just 2 weeks back called ZICOM Care. In that model, what we do is we go around, just to give you some numbers, I'm sorry, I'm going to bore you with some numbers. I think in the last 3 years, this country has installed more than 3 million CCTV systems all over. So we said if we can capture that CCTV system and we can monitor it for around 3,000 to 5,000, we got a sexy business model with us. So 2 weeks back, we launched it. So anybody's CCTV system, Honeywell, Siemens, doesn't matter, kiska hai, we can manage it. And we charge the customers starting from 3,000 rupees to 7,000 rupees. Now, what do we manage? Two things. You know, aap jab bhi dekhna, kabhi koi murder hota hai, chori hota hai, dakaiti hota hai, camera kabhi chalta hai nahi hai. Kabhi nahi chalta hai. And then they blame the system, then they blame the vendor. But the fact of the matter is, nobody was monitoring it. So, jab chahiye, tabhi chalta nahi hai. So what we do is, like a patient goes into an ICU, to usko pura cable laga dete hai na, so we connect that recording device to our office and we are constantly monitoring to see kisi ne switch off to nahi kiya, koi camera to band nahi hua, kisi ne power band to nahi kiya. So we are like the doctors monitoring the health, part one. Part two, when people go home at night, like you have your institutes, let's say you went to sleep at night, cameras always record a crime. It never prevents a crime. We know that. Camera can never prevent a crime. We said we must make cameras prevent a crime. So we started a concept called as virtual security guard, the same incident of ATM. So when somebody walks into your, let's say your coaching classes, God, I'm not wanting that.
No, we are fully insured. We have been robbed many times. It has proved beneficial. We replace the computers with brand new ones.
It's another business model. So anyways, if the thief walks inside, the camera catches the motion, sends the image to our command center. My guys are watching, talking, shouting, and then calling the police. So here the camera becomes proactive. Here the cameras react. The camera prevents. So that's the model. Hardly costs 3,000 to 9,000, depending on some
size of the
site and all that stuff. And per year, I'm talking about. It is not per month, it's per year. Now, if you pay a watchman, even 10,000 rupees or even 8,000 rupees, 1 lakh per year, you pay us 8,000 rupees. We'll do the same job for you, except for cleaning up.
So all the time you're innovating your business model, you're looking at your balance sheet, you're trying to restructure your financial arrangements, at the same time trying to do something which nobody else is doing in the industry.
Yeah, I always believe that ideas are not patented by anybody. Anybody will come and copy it. So in my career, I started with fax machine, like washing machine, then we got into modems. In those days, modems, 2 lakh rupees, Rajesh, it's a lot of money. Eh? So pagers, mobiles, and then security, now security service. So I've always been in concepts, the new ones. It is very challenging, but very fun.
Do you bounce off your ideas to a particular group of people to check whether it's the right idea, or you take a bold decision, start implementing and thinking ki jo hoga, dekh lenge?
Depends, you know. It's been both, to be very honest. But when I'm very convinced about a particular idea, I personally drive.
Have you gone back on a decision?
Many times. And I'll tell you, out of 10 times, 8 times we make mistakes also. There's nothing great about it. But theek hai, two successes is good for us.
Was those beneficial mistakes which helped you the next step or what?
I said just now, no, we are WIP. So, and you know, very honestly, Rajesh, when I look back at my life, I feel that we started as what? Yeah. So everything on a balance sheet is plus only. No?
You're into the retail business. So what is your method of sales? Channel partners and online sites? Or how is it?
So we have about 2,000 channel partners that buy our product across the country. And they're quite loyal to us. But channel partner being loyal is a little, you know, dicey thing. But so far they're loyal. Having said that, online we're just trying. We're targeting the home consumers there. Because, you know, our channel partners don't want to go home. Because ghar jaate to father become decision maker, mother, grandmother, grandfather, children. So he's so stressed. And then finally the housewife will say, ab kal aana, parso aana. So he doesn't want to go there. So we felt online is a better way to sell for homes. So we are focusing online only for B2C, not B2B.
So you are focusing on DIY products, do-it-yourself
yeah.
products?
Yeah, yeah. But DIY, we bolte hain, but everybody wants some, you know, apne ghar pe fridge bhi aata to socket mein hum log wo aake laga ke jata hai. So, theek hai, yeah, we call it DIY, but we do the installation.
In your growth story, what has been your man management strategy?
Five things. First thing, I believe business and life is all about focus. So, the five F's of my business. So, I
know those five F's.
You know.
Focus, fun, flexibility.
Fast.
Fitness. And fitness. I'm sure being in the security industry,
the
you are maintaining
is,
that.
If you don't enjoy, if you're not having fun, if you're not having focus, if you're not flexible, if you're not fast, if you're not fit, then you fish off.
That is the seventh F. There is an eighth one also, we can't say that on camera. But that's excellent. What are your global expansion plans? How do you devise that?
Well, you know, I have stopped thinking global. I think local only. Because I think India has got fantastic potential and we have not even scratched the surface. We're doing a bad job of that. So I might as well focus on my country. I think this country has a lot to offer us.
Well, India is a world in a country by itself. So I Absolutely. Think there is no need to look outside.
There's no need to go anywhere. Yeah.
Security is a very competitive market. Like most of the businesses that we operate into are heavily competitive in nature. Even your industry. Yeah. How do you handle your competition? And what do you learn or what do you teach your competition?
Well, I can't teach my competition. I'm not that good to teach my competition. But I think competition is good. Everybody agrees. I mean, everybody will agree that competition is good. Okay.
Is it a compulsive statement or?
No. If business doesn't have competition, there's no business model, right?
How do you beat them?
So good question. How do you beat them? See, you cannot beat them on price because price is a bottomless pit. It never ends, right? So you have to. So customers will finally buy from the company they trust the most. It is my business all about trust. And I think in the last 20 years, we have been very focused on building trust. Now we have some brands that you must have seen, a lot of ads are coming and this. So people ask me, are tum log kuch karte nahi hai? I say, we don't want to react to somebody who's spending money. He has money, he'll spend. Our approach to business has been quite steady. Today we do lots of digital media. But just answering a question on competition, I really respect my competition, not because we are on the camera, but very honestly, I respect my competition. I admire what they do because there's lots to learn from them what we don't do. And lastly, I think competition is always very important and critical for any success of any business. So I look at it very positively.
How do you educate your customers to believe that you are better than the competition?
See, value is not what I give. Value is the customer, what he receives. So I may go and say, I'm the best company, I've got the best product, that I will say. But the customer says, boss, give it to yourself, I'm buying from somebody else. So value is always what the customer receives. So we focus on how the customer is going to see you. So if the customer sees us in a positive way, he'll buy from us. If no matter how big a brand is, the Bata is a very known brand. But how many people go to Bata and buy shoes today, right? So we are focusing on customer experiences now, rather than trying to promote the brand. Because I personally feel customers can be your best brand ambassadors. You don't need to advertise at all. And luckily for us, wherever we install our cameras or wherever our brand is seen, That's great brand building. You don't have to spend money.
And how do you help your company to have customer retention? Because that's also become very important in a product like security.
You know, Rajesh, there are, like any good organization, we have a lot of internal systems, SLAs, dashboards. We manage them. And fortunately for us, the churn has been very low. Even in our business of putting cameras in housing society is a huge challenge. Because chairman, secretary, treasurer, then committee members, and then it's a nightmare. But there also our churn is below 5%. And I think 5% is good because that churn also is because a lot of customers don't pay, so we remove the system from there. So all that put together 5%, and I think any business 5% churn is still okay.
You have a very good way of communicating to the large audience. I've seen a couple of your television ads. They're very interesting and intelligent. So are these your inputs to the ad company which does it for you?
No. It's all their brains. I don't use it. Recently, we hired a very interesting guy called Tarun Chauhan. He's now working for the launch of 4G. So he's helping us in a brand strategy now. So we got the best brains, the best digital media agency with us. Very large, very good. So I believe that when you have your core team very good, your job gets automated done. You don't have to use your brains. And I don't have that kind of brain power which these guys bring in, you know. This gentleman does fabulous work. So he's engaged with us now.
Was it a right decision to sell a part of your company to Schneider?
Of course. I think no regrets on whatever we do. I never look back and regret anything in my
life.
So
do you activate the same business again now, or that's a dead story for
you?
We
started that business. There are a lot of smart city projects coming. But it's all on paper. There's so much of hype around smart cities. But whenever that happens, we'll be there in that business for sure.
What is your thought on the future of this country? Because I think there are some great business opportunities unfolding. Smart cities have been launched, and definitely security is one of the biggest concerns for any country, including India. So what do you see as a future for your business in India?
Two things. One thing, if you look at the human needs, you know, I think 10, 15 years back, it was roti, kapda, makan. It stopped there. In the new era, it is roti, kapda, makan, or security. So that got added. So it's good for us. Sorry about this, but that's our business, unfortunately. We're like doctors and lawyers. If there's no murder, no robbery, nobody wants us. So that's number one. Part two, you asked me, how do you see this country? Personally, I'm still not very sure about this new government that has come. All of us voted, aspirations and all. So I want to keep that question aside. Security business in this country is growing at the rate of 20-30%. And I see that accelerating as we go forward. I think the next big thing that is going to happen in the space of security is connecting the dots between your mobile phone and your home, mobile phone and your office, and those kind of stuff which is already happening. Every day I get people asking me, mere ghar pe camera lagane ka hai, mere ko mobile pe dekhna hai, mere bachi ko dekhna hai, mere mates ko dekhna hai. And there are some amazing incidents that we get to know after they put the camera at home. So I believe that there's lots that's going to happen. It's not even, nothing much has happened so far.
I think entrepreneurship is one activity which should really multiply in this country to move forward. What is your one strong message to budding entrepreneurs and entrepreneurs who want to expand?
Oh, I am so amazed and in awe of this young generation that is coming. I go for many of these seminars and I hear them. I feel I'm completely outdated when I sit with them. This talent in this country is so good. I mean, it's amazing. You know, it's very inspiring for old people like me when I sit with them to see how good they think, you know. So I see a very, very good future in this country for these young minds and young brains. And I think what we took 20 years to make, they may do it in less than 5 years. And that's the speed. These boys and girls are very restless. They are unconventional in their thinking. They don't think like what we think are a slow, incremental growth. They don't believe in that story of small incremental growth. They all think about inorganic growth. So having said that, I am very, very bullish. I'm very ecstatic about the new generation. Unfortunately, we got born a little early, you know. But having said that, these guys are a bunch of amazing, and I'm if I have to put my money, I'll put on these guys.
As the last question from my side before the audience starts the interaction, share one successful strategy which changed the course of your company.
In ZICOM?
In ZICOM, yes.
There are many, but I'll give one example of it. So when we were ideating for the SaaS model, we looked at the enterprise business and we called something called as Make Your City Safe. I'll talk about our Make Your City Safe model. So we looked at an average human being and we said, what are his security needs? So I realized that whenever there's anything happens in the city, like Bombay mein kal kuch chori, kuch dakaiti hota hai, ya kuch rioting hota hai, for us, our home is the safest place, right? We rush home. Kuch bhi hoga, flooding, blooding, kuch bhi hoga, we run home. So home is one place. Then outside, as soon as I open my door, there is my building. Then my wife is waiting outside for a rickshaw or a car, street. And then you come to this hotel, out of home. So there are four levels of security. Your home, level one. Your building, level two. Your environment around your building, level three. And level four, out of home. So we said, if you have to capture these four segments, how do we do with one stroke? And that was a strategy. So we said, those days of Eureka Forbes going to buildings are over now. You don't get entry like what used to get before. People stop your entry now. And there are many barriers to enter homes. So we said, if we can enter the building, we'll enter the homes. So we went to the chairman, secretary, bola, sir, aap camera mein lagate kyun nahi ho? Bola, camera kyun lagane ka, humko lagane ko zarurat nahi. So the resistance that we saw was that, A, camera lagane ke, we don't know what to buy. Kya lagane ka maulum nahi hai. Lagane ke baad wo chalega nahi to sab hum pe sabko humko sabka gaali sunna padega. Fir kaun maintain karega usko? So we told them, but sir, aaj e-commerce ki wajah se kitne log aapke building mein aate hain? Koi pizza leke aata hai, koi ye leke aata hai, wo leke aata hai, doodh wala bhaiya, ye sab. Matlab wo sab aane do. But I don't want this headache. To humne bola, theek hai sir, ek kaam karo, aap kuch bhi mat karo. Aap kharido mat, aap decide mat karo, sab humko karne do. Jaisa aapka ek watchman baitha na wahan, utna paisa hum, uska aadha paisa humko de do. Aap usko, if you are paying him 8,000, you pay me 4,000. I'm happy. So like that, we got 4,000 buildings. Now that was a strategy. She said, once we get the building, we'll get to enter the flats, level one. So we used level two to enter level one. And we used level one to go to level three, that is out of the building. So putting cameras outside the building, all that stuff. Now level four remained. So we said, now how do we make people safe when they are in a place like this? So we worked on a concept. And you know, women, a lot of women are in this room. So a lot of apps have come on women's safety and security. So we looked at all of that and I said, one of the basic problem with this app is it creates more fear than doing good things. So somebody asked me why. I said, if my wife is in trouble and she tells me I'm in trouble, I'm going to panic more. Okay? So I said, no, we should do something very different. So we built something called as response management in it. So what we do now, very simple and for the ladies. So if you ever feel threatened, use your mobile phone on a button which is on the side. Press it more than three times. That's it. Nothing more you need to do. The minute you press this button, our command center sitting in our office in Bombay, you could be anywhere in the country, doesn't matter where you are. Our command center will get to know that Mrs. So-and-so is in trouble. So he will do intelligence gathering first. What is intelligence gathering? He will first find out your location, exact location, the GPS location. So he knows where you are. At the same time, we will find out all the numbers, police station, fire brigade, ambulance, around that area. Then he will dial your mobile phone. When he dials your mobile phone will not ring. It will not ring. It's called stealth mode. So he is now picking up the conversation that is happening between you and the perpetrator who is talking to you or trying to scare you. Then your mobile phone, which is there, it switches on the front camera and the back camera without the flash coming on. And it sends us the images. And if you're on a 3G network, it also sends us the video. So now we have the audio, we have the video, we have the image, we have the location. We know exactly that you are in trouble or not in trouble, but whichever it is. And then we start the rescue management, the response management. Now that's a service we launched. So we, actually today, I shouldn't be saying this on camera, I told this to Rajesh, but I'll not go to the camera. It was, the launch was today in the evening, and there was one very big dignitary who was supposed to do the launch, but then since this program was there, I had to cancel it. And tomorrow...
That big dignitary was Commissioner of Police, Mumbai.
Today it was supposed to be launched.
He can't say that, but I can say it.
And for the ladies, especially, for 1 year, the cost is, or the investment, I'm going to use the wrong word, investment is 999 rupees only. And we are right now giving it for less than 50%, 60% discount on it. Okay, so you have to only pay 300 rupees or maybe 350 rupees, whatever. That's small for the whole year of all these services. Also, what we realized is that the lady of the house is the one who takes care of all the safety. So she's also concerned about her father, mother, child. So we built two sexy services in it. What it is, you know, when your daughter leaves the house, you want to know where she is, you can track her. So that's got an automatic tracking device on it. Okay, your daughters may not like it.
What if the wife starts using it on the husband? See, husband will be ready to pay 10,000 rupees not to start the service.
You know, the knife is used to cut, the knife is used to murder. Our job is to protect. What you do with it is your... I know that. And we heard this before also. So if you want, I spoke about the child, okay? You want to know, your child goes from school to home to school, suddenly she goes somewhere here, you'll get to know, okay? That's more for child safety. And old parents, you know, some after 60, 65, 70 years, when they walk on the street, suddenly they have memory loss, they don't know where they are, and you want to know where your father is, you can easily track him wherever he is. So we have built that feature. Then we realized, Rajesh, that on our mobile phone, we have so many apps, na? Kitne sare apps hai. Hum log bhul jate hain ki apne paas kya hai andar bol ke. So like what NDTV does to you know, they keep sending you notifications. We send you every day at least one good notification, something which will help you in your life on security. Ghar band karo, chavi yahan rakho, ye karo, wo karo. So that aapko maloom hai hum log mobile pe hai jinda. It is not an app, it's an app-based service. App bolte meko, that goes into a different genre altogether. So that's our strategy. So the strategy was to enter B2C market, covering or encompassing the environment, the physical need, the personal need, and that's how we got into level one home, through level two, which is building, level three outside the home, and level four out of home. So that was
lovely. So this is your best strategy, one of the best strategies. One of the best strategies. So friends, that's Pramoud Rao for you. Let us start our... If you clap harder, he might withdraw that tap.
Did you have a plan B in mind ever in your life that in case if I quit this and I will do that thing?
No. So then he asked me that time when I was having that cup of coffee with him. Abhi tu kya karega? I said, malum nahi hai. Then he had the audacity to tell me, why don't you work for me as a regional manager? So that answers your question.
Yeah, one is related to the second last question which was asked. You know, even me and Raj had gone to a conference where all the young generation entrepreneurs were there. Now, we always wonder, you know, about all this valuation game. So, given your experience and exposure all over the world, so what is your take on this? How authentic, how real it is, or it is just blown out of proportion?
Okay. So, I recently met a fund manager, a very big guy. You know, and I asked him the same question that you're asking me. I asked him the same question. He answered me the same way. He said, "Mujhe isko samajh mein nahi aata."
Hi, sir. Now, since you're in the security business, so which itself is a very, very big responsibility on you and your team members. So, and again, it's all dependent on the technology. So, for some reason, if someday the servers or the technology fails, so any backup you have or your like, again, technology related or otherwise, so that your work is on?
Yeah, so we have we have our own data servers and we have on the cloud also. But I think the question that you were trying to ask me was on the technology. So we have all that stuff. But on the outside world, besides our office, you know, when you go outside, if villa cameras prevent a crime, the answer is yes. But at times it doesn't prevent a crime also because it doesn't work, something goes wrong, something happens. So we are like an insurance policy to a customer. We never, nowhere do we say that we will 100% guarantee you that crime will not take place. So if you exclude that, rest of it we manage. So we have good servers, cloud-based services and all that stuff. Typical IT.
So the technology is in place. Yes, Vinit.
Hello, sir. I think security is not only for robbing, maybe. If you because of amount of cost you're saying is very, very appealing. So security for a farmer is very, very important. So can, if Internet of Things is possible, if Internet of Weather or, you know, natural calamities, something like this possible?
Sir, I am in the business of electronic security, not weather management. Number two is, you mentioned cost, you know, and we have been trying to fight this word called cost, because the mindset in this country, even today, after so many years, is security is not an investment, it's a cost. People see, when I spend on security, I have to put money. So, mera kharcha hone wala hai. The day this country realizes that by putting some small, few thousands of rupees, it's an investment, will all, this whole country will not need the police department the way we need it today.
Yes, Aditya.
Yeah. So, Mr. Rao, my question was more in terms of cost of customer acquisition. So, you spoke that in terms of B2B, your business is more skewed in terms of 90% being B2B. But what's the cost of customer acquisition compared to B2C? So, is it lesser in B2B or you see it as similar?
So, I just said that 90% of our revenues today are coming from the enterprise. There, the cost of customer acquisition for us is sub 8,000 rupees. But when it comes to B2C, there's the cost of acquisition currently is going to be huge, because you know, you look at any of these portals that are trying to advertise, they're spending millions of rupees to build a brand. So right now I cannot put a number because we have not started that as yet. So, but it's going to be quite expensive initially. If you grow the volumes, then obviously the whole equation changes. So I really don't have a number on that right now. But on the enterprise, it's sub 8,000 rupees.
Dr. Rajesh.
Good evening.
Good evening, Rajesh.
We are living in a world of innovations. Every day technology is changing. And the gadgets that you are using can go obsolete very fast.
Correct.
So how do you keep yourself updated? How much time do you spend updating yourself? And what is the kind of reinvestment that you have to do to keep yourself updated?
So we do it two ways. One is that I personally visit and I read a lot on all the new technologies. So because otherwise your team will take you for a ride. So you need to be abreast of whatever is happening on the technology world. And you want to the second part is you want to validate what is happening. You travel to these large shows. I was in China last week. There was a big security show there. And I was amazed with the kind of size and scale that they have a show there. We have it in the national NSC grounds here.
NSC grounds,
you can finish the show in 2 hours. In China, I stayed for 4 days, I couldn't finish the show. It's like one hall was like one stadium. So the size was huge. So you go there and you validate your thinking, your thought processes, and say, oh, this will make sense. But what we do differently is we don't bring that thing into this country, because you can't just cut paste and bring it here. So we look at the Indian market and see what Indianization we need to do, which is very important, because if you look at the power supply here, the power keeps going all over the country and all. So those local issues are there. So we Indianize it, and then we go to the market with a strategy. We first test it in a small group and check it out, and then we go. But yes, you know, I think any entrepreneur who is there should know his business nuances. Otherwise, he'll be taken for a ride. And I don't want ever that to ever happen.
Okay, I had two questions, and I think part of it was answered when you spoke to Rajesh, where you said that the product is a little below what the service that you provide. But you spoke about the security guard getting replaced by the service that you provided. And so the 9,000 is the investment that he has to do instead of the 30,000. So my first question is, why did you price it at such a, you know, at such a price when you knew that there could be really good amount that could you have charged? So maybe, if not 30 or 40, maybe a 20 or a 25, something lesser. That was my first question. The second thing is, what was the impact of that on the business because you priced it at that?
Good. Thank you. Very nice questions. So your first question was, why did we price low? You see, that demand creation that this gentleman just spoke about, we wanted to create a demand. And Indians are now used to 60, 70, 80% discount. Every day we see paper kholte 80% discount, then we go. 20, 30, 40 doesn't appeal to us anymore. No. We're used to that. So we said we have to do that. We have to make it very attractive. So that was one of the reasons. And secondly, we are still making good money with that also, to be honest with you. So that's one part. The second part, your question was that if the guard was costing 9,000 rupees, you know, and why should we price it at this? You know, when we run businesses, we do pressure testing of price in the market. Like we recently did on that women's safety app. So we went across the country, Delhi. Surprisingly, Calcutta ladies wanted to pay more. I thought Delhi ladies should pay more. Delhi ladies said, I'll pay 150 rupees. Calcutta ladies said, I'll pay 301 rupees. There's a double. I thought the girl who's safer is willing to pay more, the girl who's unsafe is willing to pay less. So that was very strong. And surprisingly, men are willing to pay more.
Safety from whom?
So when we averaged out the country between men and women, we found that women were willing to pay 150 rupees average, and men were willing to pay 300 rupees when we priced it at 999. So if you look at the psychology again, 999 and 300 rupees is 70% discount. Around 150, 200, 80% discount. So that's how we think, and that's how we believe. So hum bhi price dalne ko chalu karega, but people should pay, no? Finally.
Lovely. I think the last question to go, Nagu.
My question is, I do agree that security is important. But are we instilling a lot of fear in the name of security? Mm-hmm. Or is that a part of the deal?
You know, we have two kinds of customer. One, who is fearing, who is by nature very fearful, you know, har cheez se dharta rehta hai. So they are our early adopters. And then there are customers, unko koi cheez se dar lagta nahi hai. So it again depends upon how, because most of the time we see things the way we are, not the way it is, right? So it depends. I'm not at all judgmental about that, because I cannot make a judgment, because we have different kinds of customer having different needs. So we had this customer who's lost a father. Kya ghar ho bichara subah uth ke doodh lane gaya kabhi aaya nahi wapas. And the whole family was in a wreck. 1 week, everybody running from hospital to hospital, morgue to morgue, posters here, posters there, please see my father, award, reward. I was just asking myself, if that lady would have used this software of ours, that whole family, that 1 week of distress and stress that they went through, they would not have gone through it. So the value is not in the price, is not in the fear. That's how, if you go to Europe and US, very, very less crimes there, but people have that nature in that, then they want to protect themselves because life is valued there. Unfortunately, in this country, life is not valued the same way it is done in the abroad. So because we see everyday people dying, murdering, killing, suddenly. So we are so used to that, because of which we feel that, you know, is the fear psychology is being put on us? Is it worse? So I'm not going to be judgmental. I leave it to the audience, the way you feel it. But personally, if not that I'm in the business, but I would say that a small price or a small investment will go a long way in protecting the safety. After all, we work so hard, we slog so much. A few thousand, apne ghar pe kitna sa faltu saman vaise bhi pada rehta hai, and which we don't use. Thoda aur ek lal dena andar.
Well, friends, I would like to conclude the subject here now. That was a very interesting conversation with him.